طيب، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. إن شاء الله، as you know my dear brother, we are now in Dhul Hijjah, and I remind myself and you to try to do as much as we can from the good deeds, because the ulama they said the a'mal in these 10 days are most beloved in the eyes of Allah than any time of the year. And this is called itlaq, mutlaq, it means no exception. Ma min ayyam here, it's mutlaq. It means there is no exception, including the last 10 days of Ramadan. The good deeds are most below in the eyes of Allah than these 10 days. And unfortunately, many people neglect these days, especially the dhikr. The dhikr in these days is extremely important and rewarded. Tayyib, inshallah, today, since we are, inshallah, close to the Eid, I will repeat this story, because this story is all the time beneficial. It's deep and it has so many lessons, and it's one of the best examples that shows the word Islam, what does it mean? Because who gave us this name is Muslim. Ibrahim. What he says? He says, رَبَّنَا وَجْعَلْنَا مُسْلِمَيْنِ لَكَ وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِنَا أُمَّةً مُسْلِمَةً لَكَ وَأَرِنَا مَنَاسِكَنَا وَتُبْ عَلَيْنَا. So Ibrahim, he says, oh Allah, make me completely obedient to you throughout my life, and make my kids fully obedient to you. So Islam, the word Muslim, means submission. أَسْلَمَ يعني إِنْقَادَ وَانْخَدَعَ. Aslama, Muslim, it means submit. That's why the best description of Islam, it means to submit your will to the will of Allah. This is called Islam. Islam is not a geographic map. It's not color scheme. It's not language. You cannot call Muslim to the people who live in Asia or North Africa. Any person who submit that there is no Lord but Allah, and Muhammad is his messenger, and he start to obey Allah, he is Muslim, even if he live in Alaska, Iceland, in an island, or anywhere in the world. So, my dear brothers, Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, ulama, they said, he was a very dynamic prophet, and he, amazing. He was having this universal concern of the deen. He was having the fikr for everybody. He was so much merciful. And he was haleem. So look, my dear brothers, in Iraq, the only person who accepts Islam is his brother's son, Lut, and Sarah. He went into the Sham, and he, by the will of Allah, asked the Lut to make effort on the tribe of Lut. Three tribes. Scholars, they said population was over 300,000 people, and they were committing sin. So he left him there, went to the Sham. From the Sham, he traveled to Egypt, came back to the Sham, went to establish complete nation, a Muslim nation in Mecca. So he was very dynamic, too much concern, a worry for how people will be saved from hell. Yani, he had this concern. And scholar, they said, second thing Ibrahim had, he was having so much attachment with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was all the time making dua. If you read the Quran, you will find the dua of Ibrahim. Rabbana, Rabbana, Rabbana. He was having attachment with Allah. He was denying his effort, his talk. And he has so much trust, tawakkul on Allah. This is one of the deepest lessons for us. How much time we talk to Allah? How much we ask Allah? How much we raise our hand to Allah? And how many issues we have? Yani, the Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam, they had connection with Allah. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam, in battlefield of Badr, it has been reported that he was making dua whole night. And he prayed Salat al-Fajr with Sahaba, then he kept making dua till almost early morning. After Ishraq, Abu Bakr Siddiq, when he sees such dua, it has never been heard by any prophet that he was raising his hand whole night in the dua. And he was repeating the same sentence, one sentence. اللهم إن تهلك هذه العصابة فلن تعبد في الأرض أبدا. Oh Allah, if this group of people will die, will lose this battlefield, you will never be worshipped on earth till the day of judgment. Same, imagine one sentence. Whole night he raises his hand and making dua. So it shows you, my dear brother, that the dua is not, it's not make dua, brother. It's not imam making dua after fard. Dua is an effort. Dua is an effort, is a quality that person can adopt. Dua is a time between you and Allah. It teach you iman, it teach you tawakkul, it teach you ikhlas, it teach you dependence on Allah. Dua is the brain of the ibadah. It has all the qualities of iman. And the more you have tawakkul, the more you have iman, the more your dua is powerful. May Allah give us tawfiq. So Ibrahim alayhi salam, my dear brothers, I will try to make the story short. When he went to Egypt, at the border of Egypt, he told to Sarah that this land has a tyrant ruler. And if he knows that you are my wife, he will kill me and take you as his wife. So if the guard asks you, who is this man? Tell him, this is my brother. And by Allah, you are my sister in Islam. So she said the same answer. So they took her as a prisoner. They put him in the jail and they took the Sarah to the king, because Sarah was extremely beautiful. So when the king saw her and he wants to commit sin with her, Ibrahim والسلام, entered in Salat. And as you know, my dear brothers, it has been reported by Rasulullah ﷺ, كَانَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِذَا حَزَّهُ أَمْرٌ فَزَعَ إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ. When Rasulullah ﷺ faced a very complicated issue, a big problem that is very difficult, first thing he do, he doesn't call people or ask people like we do. First thing he do, he go to pray. So Ibrahim ﷺ, when his wife has been taken to the king, the tyrant king, and he know he's a mushrik, he's a sinner, he entered in Salat, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Salat. Because the closest position you can be to Allah, you don't need to ask people, you know, you don't need to send a letter, you don't need to wait for a reply, you just have to make wudu and say Allahu Akbar and go into sajda. If you are in the sajda, you are so close to Allah. Rasulullah said, أَقْرَبْ مَا يَكُونُ الْعَبْدُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ وَهُوَ سَجِدْ فَأَكْثِرُ مِنَ الدُّعَى فَقَمِنُونَ. قَمِنُونَ means حَقِيقٌ, no doubt. Your dua during the sajda will be answered. So Ibrahim, when he was in the Salat, the man was trying to commit sin with Sarah. As soon as he came close to her, he became paralyzed. He cannot move. So he thought that she is the reason that he became paralyzed, because they have no iman. So he told her, release me, and by Allah I will not touch you. So she make dua to Allah. Oh Allah, release him. He has been released. Again he cheated. He wants to commit sin. He become paralyzed 3 times. Then he asked the guard and tell them, send her away. You brought me a devil. You did not brought me a human. So the Sarah and Ibrahim has been released, and he gave them Hajar. Hajar, she was very young, teenager, and he gave it to them to serve them, to do their khidmah. When Ibrahim took Hajar, this is the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Ibrahim took Hajar back to the Sham, Sarah told him, marry her. Maybe she will give you a baby. Because Sarah was not giving a baby. So when he married her, she became pregnant and she gave birth to a boy. Sarah felt jealous. A jealous here means the jealousy of woman, not the jealous, because English, they don't have the meaning of the ghayra, not the jealousy means the hasad, to know that this man will be deeper. But the ghayra is a normal on the woman. So she tell him, ghayib hadi anni, disappear this woman from my face, I don't want to see her. In short, Allah ordered Ibrahim to take Hajar and her baby to the house of Allah, Bayt Allah al-Haram. So when Ibrahim proceed, and Jibreel told him, this is the place of Allah, this is the Haram of Allah, this is the house of Allah, he give them the date and water, and he start walk away. Now look, subhanAllah, Hajar, if we want to go in details, she's a new Muslim. She accepted Islam in the hand of Ibrahim. And maybe she is 2 or 3 years that time. Because she's less than 2 years in Islam, because Ibrahim, Ismail was a baby, newborn baby. But this woman, when she accepted Islam, she learned something that we did not have now, 50 years of Islam. She learned the Iman. She learned who is Allah. She learned the power of Allah. She has that dependence on Allah. So Hajar in her story now, is a new Muslim. Like you, for example, you see someone, he just accepted Islam, and in 1 year he fly. You see his qualities of Iman, you see his tawakkul, you see how he fear Allah, how he avoid the haram, you become astonished. Why? Because he was sincere. Allah give him. This Allah does not say, you know, my dear brothers, we have no relationship with Allah. There is no question of, I am Sayyid, I am from the family of the Prophet. Allah does not know this. Allah look to your heart. If your heart is devoted and you are thirsty, you want to get, Allah will give you. Rasulullah say, إِنَّمَا أَنَا قَاسِمْ وَاللَّهُ يَهْدِي وَإِنَّمَا أَنَا دَعِيمْ إِنَّمَا أَنَا دَعِيمْ وَاللَّهُ يَهْدِي وَإِنَّمَا أَنَا قَاسِمْ وَاللَّهُ يُعْطِي. I am only an inviter, Allah is the one who give hidayah. And I am only the one who shares, and Allah is the one who give. So my dear brothers, Hajar, when she saw Ibrahim proceeding, the house of Allah that time was only sand and heat and no life. Scholar, they said even the bird, even eagles, even snakes and scorpions, one of the most wild animals, they don't live in that land. They will die. So Ibrahim was proceeding. Hajar was saying, Ya Ibrahim, and he doesn't answer. إِلَى مَنْ تَتْرُكُنَا يَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ, to whom you are leaving us here? Yani, people, they say common sense. With the common sense, can anyone leave his wife in the desert? They will consider this as a crime. You understand? This is a baby and a woman, innocent woman. So what this woman who have Iman, she has yaqeen, she has conviction that this is the Prophet, this is Rasulullah. Because Iman is two halves. Iman on Allah, it means his orders. Iman on the man that Allah sent, he is Rasulullah. Whatever he do or say is haq. I have no doubt in that. So if you doubt any hadith, suspect your Iman. You say, my Iman is so weak that I did not accept the words of Rasulullah. So Hajar, she know that Ibrahim is Khalilullah, is Nabiullah. She told him, Allahu Amarak, is it order of Allah? Is it Allah's order that I will be staying here with my baby? And you will leave us? Ibrahim, alayhi salam, he moved his head. He did not turn. Because scholar, they said, Allah told him, drop your wife and proceed back. Now, the way how Ibrahim submit to the orders of Allah, he submit even to the words, the details of the word. Look, subhanAllah, he did not try to make even ijtihad. He did not say, okay, Allah, leave me to drop this wife. Let me hug them. Let me sit with them a little bit. Let me talk to them. No. Subhanallah. Full submission. This is Islam. He did not argue. He just dropped them and proceed. So when she gave him this question, she gave him a small gap to answer. He moved with his head, yes. So she see from his back that the sign of the body language with affirmative. It is an order of Allah. Allahu Akbar. Look at this iman of this woman. Look at the reaction. She said, "Idan la yudayyuna." Then we will never be lost. Now listen, my dear brothers. Listen how this word is so precious. The word that Hajar said after saying the death. This is suicide. Desert with no life and few water that will finish. Nobody will come for the secure. She said, she did not believe in what she see. She denied what she see because she has yaqeen Allah is the creator. Then, la yudayyuna, we will never be lost. Now listen to, remember this word, la yudayyuna. Now Hajar radiallahu anha, scholar they said, when the water finish and the date finish, the baby start cry by thirst. The mother, this is newborn baby, subhanallah. The mother could not bear hearing the cry without doing anything. Scholar, they said she was so thirsty that she has even no milk, no milk on her breast, dry by thirst. So she went away to try to find someone who saved them. And look, subhanallah, the tawakkul. Tawakkul here does not, she did not cross her feet and say Allah is Qadir. No. She has deep iman and deep knowledge of how to use the tawakkul. She did what she can. She showed to Allah that she is, since Allah gave her hand and feet, tools of work, she moved. So she climbed the Safa. Rasulullah said, that time Safa was huge mountains. Till she reached the top and she start look from the four side. فَلَا تَرَى إِلَّا السَّرَابِ. She find only sarab. Sarab, it's the reflect of the heat in the sand. Nothing. Then when she come to the Safh, as soon as she come down to the end of the mountain, she hear the scream of the cry of the baby. So she doesn't wanna sit, she ran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, my dear brother, there is a green light. If you do sa'i between Safa and Marwa, there is a green light. Now in this green light, people walk normal. But once they come to this green light, they speed. You don't jog. You don't do jogging, but you just speed, rush. Scholar, they said, we rush because Hajar, subhanallah. Allah loves so much, subhanallah, even the movement of this woman. The movement of this woman, Allah make it sha'ira. Sha'ira means, scholar, they said, sha'ira means sign of ibadah. Allah make this movement a sign of ibadah till qiyamah. She did all this seven times, scholar, they said. Seven times. Seven times she had no more energy. يقول الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم حتى بلغ منها الجهد. It means she has no more effort. She completely come to do losing hope. So then, my dear brothers, scholar, they said, Allah, she heard a noise. She hear a noise. She said, if you are bringing some good, show up who you are. Then she saw Jibreel. Ulama, they said, only three women saw Jibreel. Three women saw Jibreel. The first woman is Hajar. Second woman is Maryam. Third woman is what? Who can tell us the third woman? Aisha radiallahu anha. Rasul Jibreel was talking to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam outside. And he was having the shape of Dihya al-Kalbi radiallahu anhu. Very handsome Sahabi Rasulullah used to send him to Rome. Very handsome. So Aisha, she said to Rasulullah when he came back, O Prophet of Allah, I saw you with Dihya, I did not say salam. I feel shy. So he says, that was Jibreel. He told me, who is this? I told him, this is my wife Aisha. He says to me, Rasulullah, Jibreel tell to Rasulullah, أَمَا إِنَّهَا لَوْ سَلَّمَتْ عَلَيْنَا لَرَدَدْنَا عَلَيْهَا السَّلَامِ. By Allah, if she said to us, Assalamu alaikum, we will return back salam to her.
Sarah also saw.
Yeah, this is inshallah, brother, no problem. Inshallah. They come as a guest. Yeah, Jibreel make it. He's right. Alhamdulillah. Jazakumullah. طيب, let's come back to our topic, inshallah. Sallu ala al-Habib. طيب, my dear brothers, Jibreel come on his picture. Now listen, Jibreel, whatever he says, whatever he do is an order of Allah. It's a revelation. What is the first word when he hit with his wings and the water blew like a fountain? She come and she says Zam. Zam, it means she starts gather the sand on it. Rasulullah say, if Hajar did not cover the water with the sand, it will be a river that will flow till the day of judgment. So the angel Jibreel, the first word he says, لا تخاف الضيعة. Allahu Akbar. The first, last word Hajar tell to Ibrahim, إِذَنْ لَا يُضَيِّعُنَا. Allah will never get us lost. Jibreel come with the first word from Allah, لا تخاف الضيعة. Don't be afraid to be lost. My dear brothers, we have to ponder over our Islam, my dear brothers. How we can be afraid to be lost if you have connection with Allah? Yani Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say to Abdullah ibn Umar, to Abdullah ibn Abbas, احفظ الله يحفظك. You deal with Allah, Allah will deal with you the same. Protect the orders of Allah, Allah will protect you. Allah will protect your kids. Allah will protect your wife. Allah will protect your generation till the day of judgment. Allah is the protector. Allah al-Hafidh. Wallahu khayrun hafidha. So many brothers, he says to her, this is the house of Allah, and this baby will build the house of Allah with his father Ibrahim. Why he told her this is the house of Allah and it was only sand? Because the house of Allah, as you know, my dear brother, has been built by the angels before Adam. Adam rebuilt it, Nuh rebuilt it, and it has been destroyed by the Tufan, and Ibrahim rebuilt it. Ibrahim alayhi salatu was salam, when he proceeded, my dear brothers, we come back to Ibrahim, when he came down to the mountains, from the mountains, and they did not see him, he turned towards the Qibla. He faced the Qibla, but Hajar does not see him. And he raised his hand. قَالَ رَبَّنَا إِنِّي أَسْكَنْتُ مِنْ دُرِّيَّةِ بِوَادٍ غَيْرِ ذِي زَرْعٍ عِنْدَ بَيْتِكَ الْمُحَرَّمِ رَبَّنَا لِيُقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ رَبَّنَا فَاجْعَلْ أَفْئِدَةً مِنَ النَّاسِ تَهْوِي إِلَيْهِمْ وَارْزُقْهُمْ مِنَ الثَّمَرَاتِ. Allah granted the dua of Ibrahim as he said it. Why? Because he sacrificed for the deen. He submit to the orders of Allah. Allah grant his dua by words. He said, oh Allah, I left my family in a place that has no source of life. The purpose is to establish your deen, to establish the salat. Oh Allah, make such a people will come to join them and sustain them from your khaza'in. Allah give him the answer as he said, and he proceed. When the water came, Jurhum, the tribe of Jurhum from Yemen, that time they used to look for water, they find a bird, eagle, moving around. So they said, this place has no water. So when they come, they find Hajar and Ismail, the baby, and the well of Zamzam. They told her, can you suffice us the water, and we will give you the food? She said, yes. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted the dua of Ibrahim, and the tribe of Jurhum established, and Ibrahim, Ismail grew up with them. They teach him hunting. When he turned 10 years old, and some scholars they said 12, Ibrahim has been taken permission by Allah to come and see Ismail. That time Ibrahim did not have Ishaq yet. So when he came, he saw the baby young, and he returned back with his love. And he see him, mashallah, smart, moving, talking, etc. So he came back with his love. Now, the love, Rasulullah used to love his wife, Aisha. He used to love her sweet. And the Anbiya they love. But Ibrahim is Khalilullah. As Rasulullah is Khalilullah. So Allah wants to test him with this love. Whether this love more than Allah or the love of Allah more than his son. So he saw in a dream that he slaughtered him. So he came back to do Mashura with his son. قال يا بني إني أرى في المنام أني أذبحك فانظر ماذا ترى. انظر ماذا ترى, it means what is your opinion. Now scholar they said he did not say this because he wants to see his descent. No, but he just wants to see the reaction of the son of the boy, or else he will submit to the word of Allah, no doubt. So the son answered with conviction. Look, subhanallah, who teaches Ismail this conviction? Look, subhanAllah, remember what Hajar say, إِذَا لَا يُضَيِّعُنَا. This is the talk of Siddiqeen, the talk of people who does not believe, are not affected with the means and asbab. They have full yaqeen in Allah. Ismail, 12 years old, he says, يا أبتي افعل ما تؤمر ستجدني إن شاء الله من الصابرين. Oh Allah, do what Allah ordered you to do, you'll find me among the patients. Scholar, they said, who teach the boy this iman? Hajar, tell him the story. Hajar, the mother, tell her son how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with his qudra sustained them, how Allah bring the tribe, how Allah suffice them, how Allah gave them all this asbab till she become like a queen. Allah give her tamkeen, Allah give her dignity, Allah give her asbab, rizq from the means that they did not expect. Subhanallah, this is, my dear brothers, what make Ismail heart is full of iman, full of conviction. He said, oh father, do what Allah order you to do. Now the story is very long, but in short, Ismail, my dear brothers, scholar, they said, he submit to the Lord of Allah. He tell to his son, father, tie your clothes and put them up so the blood will not come on the clothes and you will said, my mother will be said. Tight me with the rope, so if I shake, I will not disturb your knife. So, and he put him towards the face towards the ground. Tallahu lil jabin, it means the face on the ground, so he cannot see him and have mercy on him. Scholar, they said he took the knife and he put the knife on the neck and he pulled with all his power. With all his power, imagine, my dear brother, the knife is sharp. The knife is on the neck, the face is on the ground, and he's pulling with all his power. Allah ordered the knife to not cut. Because, my dear brother scholar, they said, this is asbab. The fire, the knife, the water, the food, they are not having this power to fill us. The creation, the shab', the ray, the slaughtering, those are created actions that are made by Allah. Allah is the creator of this af'al. The knife cannot cut by its will. So when he pulled the knife, Allah ordered the knife to not create this quality. Allah is the one who created. So knife was not doing anything. So on the third time, Jibreel hold the hand of Ibrahim and in the other hand show him the sheep. Allah said in the Quran, فلما أسلم وتله للجليل جبين ناديناه يا إبراهيم قد صدقت الرؤيا إن هذا لهو البلاء المبين وفديناه بذبح عظيم. سلام على إبراهيم. السلام عليكم.